From a condition when people are born with extra fingers and toes to salamanders that can regenerate limbs, the key to the answers of these phenomena lie in understanding vertebrate limb development. Let's get started. We begin on the embryo and structures known as limb buds. Inside is a mass of cells eager to begin their journey to limb development. Like a puzzle has many pieces, each at specific locations, our cells will grow to specific spots on our limb respective to three axes. These are known as proximal distal, which is shoulder to finger, anterior posterior, which is thumb to pinky, and dorsal ventral, which is outer to inner arm. Next, once in the right spots, just like nearby puzzle pieces create small images, cells in the same region form different tissues. From there, as images create our puzzle's overall picture, these correctly placed tissues create our limb. Now, the science behind limb development revolves around ensuring cells develop specific tissues at the correct locations. This is done via molecules in the limb bud, which control cell growth and developmental location on the three axes by interacting with special genes in their DNA. As for specifics, studies on chicken embryos have shown us the most important molecules, where they are found, and which axes they control. First, talking proximal distal, a region on the tip of the limb bud known as the AER produces molecules called FGFs. These tell limb bud cells to grow outward. As growth occurs, cells and tissue structures find their location on this horizontal axis. Next, let's consider anterior posterior. A region located on the posterior of the limb bud known as the ZPA produces a molecule amazingly called sonic hedgehog on a concentration gradient. Cells exposed to the higher concentrations develop tissues towards the posterior, whereas those exposed to the lower concentrations develop towards the anterior, finding the correct places on the second axis. Now, let's talk dorsal ventral. A molecule called Wnt7a is found in high amounts on the dorsal side of the limb bud. It tells cells to develop structures dorsally, whereas its absence below, along with some other molecules, tells cells there to grow ventrally, controlling this last axis. Generalizing from chicken, these molecules work together and ensure cells and tissues develop at the correct locations on our three axes, creating a limb just like a puzzle.
This topic is so cool because it provides the answers to many incredible questions. First, limb development serves as a model for how other bodily structures form. Second, we can now also better address abnormal limb developments. For example, polydactyly has been linked to incorrect sonic hedgehog signaling.
Furthermore, those studying salamanders such as the axolotl and their Deadpool-like limb regeneration use limb development foundations to better understand the phenomena and have in fact found parallels between the two processes.
With research like this setting the stage for future promise, our studies in vertebrate limb development may very well change our world. Thanks for watching.